Hello, YouTube! This is Sam Q here, and today we're gonna check out Robin's kit and her signature light bulb. And let's see what she's all about, and if she's, and how good could she be as a support. Whether she'd be better or equal to Rune Main or Sparkle or Lesser, depends. Let's look at it. So, here we have Robin, her character preview, looking beautiful as always. She is a physical type harmony character who is a support type character that can increase the damage of the team through concerto. Activating concerto can allow the entire team to take immediate action. Whoa, that's really good. While concerto is active, additional damage will be triggered after allies attack. Additionally, after allies use their attacks, Robin additionally regenerates energy. So, with this, it means there is a possibility that her concerto will have a really good uptime because she also regenerates energy while her concerto is active. So maybe we can use her concerto again after it's over. That's really good, looking good. And she is so good. Now let's look at the character preview. Robin is a Halovian singer who was born in Pelicani and has risen to Cosmic Frame, an elegant and demure young lady. This time, she has been invited home by the family to grace everyone with the song during the Charmony Festival. She can use the power of harmony to broadcast her music, manifesting resonance among not only her fans, but all manner of life forms. So, person matters, we're our first meeting. Hello, good evening. I'm Robin, a singer from the family. No need for formalities. It's just a friendly offstage chat. It's been a moment. Chat records. In order to capture the essence of a song, those before us encapsulated music on physical records. My collection is from different worlds, some from civilizations that have faded away, but the feelings they left behind are eternal. And her hobbies are, sometimes I just put on a wig, change my makeup, and slip on a pair of glasses just like that. Oh, just like in the commercial. The colors. I can go anywhere without a word. Yes, so she goes undercover during her off time. And may you find peace in some. Alright. Now, let's look at her traces. I think we should look. And then we can look at the traces. So, her first trace is, when the battle begins, this character's action is advanced forward. So, this means that Robin, you don't need to have a bond lock because she herself already advances her own actions. Okay, so impromptu flourish. Well, in concerto state, increases all allies' crit damage when launching power attacks. So, it seems that Robin is a follow-up attack character support, which is really good. We have Rune Mei for all types of damage and most likely break effects and BOTs. We have Sparkle for helping carries with her crit damage bonus, and her skill points. And we have Robin for follow-up attacks, which usually uses dual DPSs. So, and her third trace is sequential passage. When using skill, additionally regenerates energy. So, it means that she can really gain her ultimate really, really fast. So, here are her 11 materials. Some are new, some are old. I don't know. And now, let's check out her idol animation. Damn, she got her birds. Maybe she sings in her idol, I don't know. Hopefully, we'll see when she will be released. Now, let's look at her basic attack. Her basic attack, wing flip white noise. It deals physical damage to a single enemy target. Nothing special here, just a normal basic attack. Just like any other character that has a normal basic attack. So, let's look at her talent. Her talent, tonal resonance, increases all allies' crit damage. Also, after all allies attack enemy targets, Robin additionally energy for herself. Wait, isn't this her Trace? No, it's just additional. So, on top of her energy, she also has a talent for it. So, probably Robin will have no issues activating her talent, which gives us another turn due to the action advance. Alright, now let's look at her skill. Her skill allows Robin to increase the damage dealt by all allies by a certain number of turns. This duration decreases by 1 at the start of Robin's turn. So, I think this is very similar to a running Mei's talent of the damage bonus. I don't know the difference if it's different type of damage bonus or not. But it's very similar, including the way the duration decreases. So maybe we can use a Robin, a very slow Robin with high attack and crit damage to be able to just activate this and have the allies regenerate energy for her. So this, which is really good to have Robin not needing speed, which also synergizes with her, with one of her traces, which acts like Bonwa. So you can really play a slow Robin and just support. So, and finally, let's look at her ultimate. Vox Harmonica, Opus Cosmic. Harmonic, Opus Cosmic, okay. Robin enters the concerto state and allows all allies except herself to immediately take action. Robin enters the concerto state, increases all allies' attack. So, which is really good because compared to Ranmei and Sparkle, she's one of the characters, limited 5-star characters, that will give us attack based on Robin's attack, just like Damien. And after every attack launched by allies, Robin will dish an additional physical damage based on her attack one time. Okay, so one time per every ally. Let's see. Crit rate and crit damage for this damage have fixed values. Okay. While Concerto is active, Robin is immune to crowd control debuffs, which is really good because you don't want Robin to be crowd controlled when you're trying to deal damage with her. Before Concerto ends, Robin will not enter her turn and cannot take action. Oh, okay. So that's a balancing thing, so she can't just use her skill again, maybe due to energy. After her ultimate, she can use her skill and activate it again, which is really good, but I think it will be super broken. A countdown for Concerto appears on the action order. When the countdown starts its turn, Robin will exit the Concerto state and immediately take action. Anyway, oh, I guess I'm wrong. She can take action again. And the countdown has a fixed speed. Okay, which is very good. And Ace. So her technique is, let's look at it. Overture of Inebriation. Inebriation. After using technique, creates a dimension around the character that lasts for a certain period of time. Enemies within this dimension will not attack Robin and will follow Robin while the dimension is active. After entering battle, while the dimension is active, Robin regenerates energy at the start of each wave. Only one dimension created by allies can exist at the time. Same time. This technique is really good in grouping up enemies, especially in simulated universe, so you can just group up the enemies and fight them in a single battle instead of fighting them one by one. And also, it's really helpful if you don't have Akron to just swipe the enemies out. So that's her kit. So my thoughts on her kit are that she will be a really good support harmony unit, mostly helping follow-up attackers, which which she synergizes with her ultimate and to deal more damage since follow-up attackers do a lot of follow-up attack and do a lot of attacks and which activates her ultimate attacks. So, which is really good. But I think she can also be used in dual defense that doesn't necessarily use follow-up attacks because if you just have a fast character or two DPS with her attack buffs and damage bonuses and action advances, I think she alone can support dual DPSs even if they're not necessarily follow-up attacks. And with that, you can say that Robin is a really good physical harmony unit. Now, let's look at her light cone. Okay, so for Robin's signature light cone in her banner, in the banner for signature light cone, we have this one, which is a very good image of Robin getting ready for a performance. So let's look at it. Like this, it is a physical harmony light cone, flowing light cone, 952 HP and 635 attack and 463 defense, which is really good, I think. So, what is her light cone's ability? Passive. The wearer gains one stack of cantillation every time any ally attacks. Each stack of cantillation increases the wearer's energy regeneration rate by 3% up to 5 stacks. When the wearer uses the ultimate, removes cantillation and gains cadenza. Cadenza increases the wearer's attack by 48% and increases the team's damage dealt by 24% lasting for 1 turn. And here, upgrade materials. So, with regards to Robin's light cone, I think this light cone will be very good in making her gameplay feel very comfortable and allowing her to support her team very more. So, it gives energy regeneration rate, attack, and damage bonus. The thing is, the wearer's attack increase to Robin, maybe it synergizes with her attack bonus that she will give to allies, and that's really good, and more damage percent is good, more damage percent. And depending on how her energy cycle or control rate, this light cone will be very recommended for maybe activating her ultimate a little bit faster or keeping the uptime for her ultimate to be good. The uptime of her ultimate will be good with this light cone. But you may not need it for her if for some reason she does not need the energy regeneration rate given by the pacifier. If she does not need it, maybe there are better light cones, but with regards to her energy regeneration, it will depend. And for the attack percent and the damage percent bonus, I think it's really good, but I don't know how much does it increase your actual damage compared to just slapping different like harmony light cones. But I think this light cone, just like any other light cones for limited characters, will be the best in slap on her, especially because it just synergizes really well with her whole kit. But I don't think it will be necessary depending on how her energy and stuff functions. But you can still get it for comfort and other things. And more damage. Ah, yes, okay. So let's look at the 4-star light cone, which is a picture. is this Black Swan? And Akron dancing during the chant in balcony, boundless fun. Yeah. So let's look at the stats. It's 952 HP, 476 attack, and 330 defense. It's a Nihility Light Cone, which has the ability of increases the wearer's crit rate by 8%. The wearer deals 24% more crit damage to enemies that are currently defense reduced or slow. I think this is a good free-to-play light cone for DPS characters that are Nihility, such as Welt and Akron herself. Whether I think this is really good, but whether it will actually be super better than any other light cones, we will see. But I think the simple fact that at S1 gives 8% crit rate and 24% crit damage, it's really good for us, for free-to-play players, because farming artifacts is really hard, you know? And we don't really have to worry about the defense reduction or slow when it comes to Nihility DPSs, because most Nihility DPSs uses defense reduction or slow mechanics to increase their damage. Maybe with this, we can finally play DPS Pella, just like the game intended. So, now let's look at the other light cones that will be in her signature light cone band. So we have the Swordplay, which is a really good hunt light cone. Aside from the ship of something, aside from the ship, it's the best, it's not free-to-play light cone. Yeah, that's it. Four hand characters. And we have Perfect Timing, which is a really good abundance light cone that increases the wearer's effect rest and healing, which is really good if you don't want your abundance characters to be crowd controlled by demons. And with that, we're done with today's video and Robin's light cone and as well as her kit. So what you guys think about her light cone, whether it will be good or bad, or I don't know, it would probably be good. It's the best insight for her because I don't think any other light cone will provide the same benefits as her signature light cone on Robin. So if you want comfort, you should totally pull for her light cone. And Robin herself is a really good unit, and that just increases the damage on your account, especially if you don't have many other supports. You can just slap in Robin and run your DPSs if you don't like running Harmony characters usually. If you like your DPS just to cover all types of weakness, you can just run Robin and everyone will have a good time. So that's it for today's video. Thank you guys for watching, and this is my first impressions and information reaction on Robin's kit and signature light cone. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to like and subscribe. Share your thoughts down below in the comment section, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye!